Excellency, members of the task force led here by Professor Adam Solo, all other distinguished guests here, ladies and gentlemen, hamjambo. Hamjambo tena. Leo ni Leo. This is the day that many people have been waiting for. And yesterday, you remember, Your Excellency, I hesitated from saying that we are going to receive the report today. But today, finally, nyoka imetoka. We now have a report, and people can now talk about a report. There have been people who have been speculating about the report without reading it. Some even have expressed a position to it before they've seen it. But finally, it is here. Yeah. We say that after long deliberation among between us, the two of us, it took hours, we identified what we saw as the problems which are actually ailing our country. And we decided that we should take steps to resolve these problems, not just for ourselves, but in the interests of this generation and the future generation of our country. Because we ask ourselves, we have a new constitution. At that time, it was 8 years. And we said, but still there are problems. So there must be other issues which are making us not enjoy what the founding fathers of our nation wanted. A country where justice are shield and defender, and the world in unity, peace and liberty. And finally, plenty is found within our borders. So far, we don't have that, the plenty. 56 years since we got independence. And that's why Kenyans are angry. Because they are hungry. An angry person is an angry person. And we identified the issues and we put them in the memorandum of understanding. There are 9 points which we charge these eminent Kenyans the responsibility of trying to find solutions. So after moving around and talking to Kenyans, they came up with a report. And then thereafter, we decided to reappoint them, rather than bringing a new team, new faces, to go and try to validate this report among the people of Kenya. They has already, Tom has explained, held town hall meetings. But we decided ourselves that we will go around and talk to Kenyans generally. And we came up with the concept of regional consultations. And the first regional consultation took place here in Kisii. Just across the wall, down there is where it was. That's where we had the lengthy deliberations. We had the experts explaining. And here in Kisii, we brought in people from all the 6 counties of former Nyanza province. So here, you had the Luos, the Kisii's, and the Kuria's came here, their representatives. Kisii County had, I think, 500 delegates. The rest had 300 mixed. Some were elders, some were women, some were youth, some were politicians, religious leaders, businessmen, all assembled here. And after lengthy deliberation, after the report was presented by the experts and people deliberated, we then retreated to the stadium where we were yesterday. to launch the BBI. And that's where the rigging started. And that's why yesterday I said we decided to come here yesterday. And I said today we decided deliberately with the president to come and receive the report here in Kisii. Because this is where it started. And regularly potoka hapa kanguruma huko magharibi. As you said here, the Kisii spoke a lot about issues affecting the Kisii region, issues which are specific to this region. Like you've seen the soapstone products outside there. He talks about them. He talks about minerals generally in this area. They talked about agriculture. They talked about industries in this region. Down around the lake there, they talked about fishing industry. They talked about sugar industry, that area. They talked about groundnuts growing, about cotton and industrialization generally in that area, and also issues of infrastructure. The couriers came with the issue because couriers are in Migori County and they are saying that they don't think they're getting their fair share. Some people are making noise. I said, no, that's why we're doing this consultation. Let everybody speak. Then we can be able to find a solution. As we moved on, it turned out it was not just only couriers having this problem. If you went to Western, the suburbs of Mount Kenya were talking about how they're also not being fairly treated there. They're not getting their rights. The Tesos in Busia had similar issues. So then say that we must find a way in this new constitution in which we find a way of how we can isolate problems affecting minorities and finding how to address them. Tulipotoka ingo, tumekaenda huko Mombasa. Kule watu wa pwani wakafoka, wakakohoa. Mambo ya madini, they talked about. They talked about the blue economy in the coast. They talked about historical land marginalization, including Mazrui land rights and all those sort of things. So very serious issues were raised. Then from there to Kaenda Ukambani, the campus also talked about issues of drought, issues of famine, you know, issues of national calamities, and also infrastructure. To Kaenda Huko Narok, Narok Pale Wamasai Waliongea, they talked about issues of land. There, how their land had been invaded, there's certain specific land that they talked about, and they wanted a solution to the issue of land. They talked about pastoralism as a way of life, and how we can do value addition, things like putting up a meat processing plant in Narok. Then they talked about the game park, which you have Masai Mara, and then you have also Amboseli, and that they wanted this to be under the county. We then went to Garissa, and in Garissa, Wariahi, Walikohoa, from Mandera, Wajir, all the way up to Garissa, but even to the people from Marsabit joined at Isiolo. And there they talked about issues of pastoralism, issues of infrastructure, issues of education, issues of security generally, the threat to the Al-Shabaab and so on. And all this, greed could need to be addressed. From there tukaenda huko Mlimani, Mount Kenya, kule Meru. Watu wa Mlima kutoka huko Nakuru mpaka Tharaka Nithi waliongea shida zao, the issues of land, issues of industrialization, issues of infrastructure, and issues of equity. The issue of one man, one shilling was very loud there, that, so that each and every Kenyan gets their rights here. So through this process, we managed to really get what is ailing Kenya, what are the problems. So it was not a useless exercise. Some people can stand and say, oh, waste of time, we need to address the issues of poverty, what we are chini, what we are dogo. I said, what? How do you address them if you don't know them? So he said, we want the Kenyan to speak, and the Kenyan spoke. Somebody will come and say, today is when you have now discovered that kuna watu wadogo. We want to have a conversation about the people with the poor man, the common man, the mkukukuteni, driver, mtu wa wilbaro, and so on. But you have been there all this time. Did you come from heaven? You didn't drop from heaven like an angel. You've been around. Is it the first time you've now discovered that there are what we are mukutukuhoteni? And the issue of haves and have nots. If you're really concerned, why are you giving them wheelbarrows? Why don't you give them your helicopter? We are going to talk to the people of Kenya. The Kenyans must know the truth. But this, sisi si watu wazimu. Mimi na ndugu yangu tuliamua tutaenda njia hii kwa sababu tunajua hii ndio njia ya kukomboa Kenya. There's no other way. This is how you're going to do it. And as Thomas said, the conversation is now beginning. And I'm sure shortly you're going to be able to get a consensus. Consensus, the issue of gender inclusivity, for example, in Parliament. And we say that we take Parliament as an institution, National Assembly and the Senate. And then once we put that together, then we deal with the issue of gender parity there. And we are determined to achieve that now, before the next election. So we are open to everything else. So Kenya, the new Kenya, must need to be born. And we, this is what we want. We said we want to bequeath a better society to the future generation. It is not about making a Odinga president or making Uhuru Kenyatta prime minister. That is propaganda. That is propaganda. The facts are those that we have said. So we want to thank these eminent Kenyans for agreeing and taking up the challenge and burning the midnight oil to come up with this document. I want it to be understood that these are recommendations that have come with as an after engagement with the people of Kenya. They are not cast in stone. They will give it to us, we will look at them, and we will also give it to our people to look at, and then hereafter we will come up now with the final document which we are going to take. The roadmap is we are going to collect signatures. We want signatures to be collected. And then we will take it to the Electoral Commission. And from there it will go to the county assemblies. And we hope that we can get 24 county assemblies to approve within 1 week. And thereafter we go to Bunge. From there tunaenda kwa wananchi wa Kenya. Sasa wewe sema yako, sisi tunasema yetu. Wakenya watamua. Na wakiamua, wewe, sisi tutakubali matokeo ya Wakenya. Bila Wakenya watakuwa watamua. Hiyo ndio demokrasia bila inafanya kazi. Asanteni sana. Karibu.